said from what service I was to the people.
I was a peasant girl from Germany. Blue-eyed, rosy, happy and strong. And the first place that I worked was at Thomas Green's. On a summer's day, she was away. And he stole into the kitchen, taking me in his arms, kissing me on my throat. I turned my head. And then, neither of us seemed to know what had happened. And I cried for what would become of me. And I cried and cried as my secret began to show. Later, Mrs. Green said she understood, and she would make no trouble for me. Being childless, she would adopt it. He had given her a father to be still. So she took to her home and sent out rumors as if it were going to happen to her. And though all went well, and the baby was born, they were so kind to me. Later, I married Gus Burton and years passed. But at political rallies, when passers-by thought I was crying at the eloquence of Hamilton Green, that was not it.
Accused me and promised me mercy for my family's sake if I confessed.
And so I confessed, and begged him to keep it out of the papers, and asked the editors too. That night at home, the constable took me in every paper except for the Clarion, wrote me as a thief. Because the Old Roads was an advertiser, wanted to make an example of me. Oh, well, you know how the children cried, and how my wife pitied and hated me, and how I came to lie here.
Stood on the corner talking politics, or sat at home reading Grant's memoirs.
She was the sweetest woman. He was a consistent Christian, all in ignorance of the truth. But then, as I began to live amongst the people here, I knew how true to the life the epitaphs carved for them. But still, I chiseled whatever they gave me to chisel, making myself party of the false chronicles of the stones. Even as the historian does who writes without knowing the truth, or because his influence to hide it.
Circe Foot.
I wanted to go away to college, but Rich and Persis wouldn't help me, so I made gardens, ripped lawns, and bought John Allen's books with my earnings and toiled for the very meaning of life. I wanted to marry Ophelia Frigid, but how could I with what I earned? And there was Aunt Persis, more than 70 years old, half alive, with her throat so paralyzed that when she swallowed her, the soup ran from her mouth like a duck. A Gorman yet investing her income in mortgages and fretting all the time about notes and rents and papers. So, that morning while I was sawing wood for her and reading the dawn in between, I went into the house for a drink of water. And there she sat asleep in her chair. Down lying on the table, and a bottle of chloroform she used sometimes for an aching. I poured the chloroform into a handkerchief and held it to her nose till she died. Oh, Delia, Delia, you and Prudhon stand in my hand, and the coroner said she died of heart failure. I married Delia and got the money. Joke on you, Spoon River.
Daisy Frazier.